Good day, this is Brer Caleb, PhD, and my PhD stands for Post Hole Digger, because we continue to work on the proper foundation for the prodigal son and daughter. Is it an art to do the impossible, or should we develop a new mindset? Fact versus fiction. Today is chaos in the White House. Is it chaos created, or is it chaos developed? I think it is created and developed by the minister that claimed that he is a fantastic person. He is unfortunately also the president, and he is also the chosen one, depending who you are talking with. If you're talking with Christians, people that are the body of Christ in the United States, they claim that Trump is a special person. They have a Trumper in the White House, and they forget that the trumpets in the book of Revelation mean something completely different. So we are going to deal with a Christian oxymoron exposed again. Restorative justice. And I believe we are now at 56 or 57. Let's check out. Is it a time for new beginnings and ending that which must end now? Is there an art to do the impossible, or should we develop a new mindset? See, a new mindset is sometimes also called a paradigm shift. A paradigm shift is when you have been on one track and that's all you know, and all of a sudden you got to deal with some major changes. And for some, including myself, that can be very troublesome. So if we are looking at a new mindset, or we have to adjust, how do we adapt? I understand it's easier than it's said. Essentially, how to get unstuck. It is step by step. You feel like you're almost locked in a jar. You have to take off the lid. But how in the world can you do that? There's no easy button. There's no magic vitamin or a pill that you can swallow, or a latest book, easy to use playbook that discusses the motivation you need to get to the end game. The grit to stay in the game and reveals how to get in the zone, or whatever scientific term we use in order to flow to that new state. When we do this, we master what we once thought was impossible, getting unstuck. The most of us will experience under the triumph mismatch of alternative reality. And when I say triumph, I mean Trumpist mismatch, because so many people are again drawn in the disaster, the drama queen. He will, he shall. And we are noticing it is a spirit of rebellion, a spirit of lies. And so we're going back to the foundation. What does the Bible say? Regardless of the circumstances, Jesus said, let not him who seeks to assist until he finds. When he finds, he will be troubled. When troubled, he will marvel, and he will reign over the universe, standing at the abyss of the religion. Does the law of attraction work for the body of Christ? Did the Trojan horse, Christianity, capture the true followers of Yeshua HaMashiach, aka Jesus? That means very simple that many people know him by the name of Jesus, but his real name is Yeshua HaMashiach. So while oppressing and weakening the people of the nation and the senile Hebrew Jewish race with the holy office of the Inquisition, aided by the Knights of Malta and later the Scottish Rites, the Freemasonry, from 1540 to 1773. So we just went back about 500-600 years ago. The Roman Catholic Church have not only the right, but they have to kill the heretics by evidence. That is, the following law was among those endorsed. And this is explained by St. Thomas Aquinas of Summa as one of the presence and unchangeable laws of the Church of Rome. The heretics deserve not only to be separated from the church by excommunication, in other words, you get kicked out, but also to be severed from the world by death. Much more reason is there for heretics, as soon as they are convicted of heresy, to be not only excommunicated, but even put to death after the first and the second admonition. And if the heretic is stubborn, the church, by excommunicating him and separating him from the church, delivers him to the secular tribunal to be exterminated from the world by death. Folks, we are talking here about a group of people that think that they are King Kong. Every heretic, so that is every person that goes against the stream and is stubborn, every heretic and Protestant are condemned to death, and every oath of allegiance to the government which is Protestant or heretic is abolished by the Council of Lateran, held in 1215 by the demon pope Innocent III. See, the essence of living is not constrained, but to bring God awareness into every experience of life, creating the foundational mindset that enables one's vital energies to be channeled back into one's inner source rather than out into the world. Satanic and Luciferian symbolism is spreading like wildfires through the world, and the Vatican is no exception. If you examine the Pope, the bent cross, for instance, and the Antichrist spirit, the morals, ethics, and values of Yeshua, if we compare the morals, the ethics, and the values of Yeshua, as Brother Caleb, PhD, I do my small part in carrying out the Great Commission, but showing to observe all things the Lord commanded us to do. I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. That is what Jesus said. He said, be imitators of Elohim. In the sower and seed parable, the person must become what is portrayed as the good ground. To make any progress and advancement, the wise men and women of our distant past knew this. Acquiring self-knowledge, so we accomplish the manifestation of self-truth. Understanding the cosmology of the mind and the laws and the forces of consciousness. In other words, Jesus said, but if you will not know yourself, you dwell in poverty, and it is you who are in poverty. And this condition of intellectual poverty noted in the gospel results from man's failure to know thyself. In other words, this true self that cannot manifest in a physical body without developing the mind. Now, why am I sharing this with you? What you see right now in front of you on television, on CNN, BBC, and all those other stations with short letters, they are showing that the people that are fading away from the gospel, from the true gospel that Yeshua shared with us, they have no self-knowledge. They predicting that a man as Trump will be the Christ, the man, the chosen one. And there is nothing worse than speaking a prophecy in behalf of God that not spoke. And then watching Mr. Trump demolish everything because he suffers of a disease called narcissism. And some people think he has ADHD. Maybe it's a combination of it. But he cannot accept the fact that he lost, because in his mind, a loser is impossible, because that is how his father raised him. But if we are being an original, somebody that is special, if any love me, he will keep my words, and we will come unto him, and he will make or our abode with him. In other words, this is the old terminology. If anyone loves the Lord, you will open the door for him. Give therefore admittance unto Christ, and deny entrance to all others, to all the evil. Blessed are they who long to give their time to God, and who out themselves come from out of the hindrances of the world. Consider these things, my soul, and close the door of your senses, so that you can hear what the Lord your God speaks to you. See, listening to what God says is an art. We get so distracted, so sidetracked with everything that is going around us. But why shouldn't we? Mr. Trump claims to be a billionaire, and it turns out everything he touches falls apart. He went just about bankrupt in 2017. In February, they signed off. And it turns out that one of the buddies that sat with him in his cabinet bailed him out for $1.8 billion. But the remarkable part is that something unique happened. I discovered it when I was writing my book. I got some information out of Indonesia, and it was all in the Indonesian language, and then I got it translated into English. And I found out that Mr. Sukarno was connected with Mr. Kennedy. Very interesting. And Mr. J.F. Kennedy got assassinated, and he got killed at a time that somebody had incorporated a small company that later was sold to Mr. Trump. Now, mind you, there were 1952 when it was incorporated, and it was sold to Trump in the early 90s. So, mind you, there is a time span. But isn't it remarkable that Mr. Trump ends up with the company that was involved with the assassination of JFK? And when you say, well, how do you find out? Well, there has been extensively written about it, and people have found out that this was true. And so why is a man like Trump, that is a ultimate narcissist that only loves himself, he doesn't care for America, he cares for the people, the attention, and he cares for filling his pockets. It costs about $1.3 to $3.1 million each time that Trump goes to his place down in the south. Certain things are not always nice to repeat, but it is important to see the whole concept. everything that you see him do cost you money. It turns out now that there is a medication for the COVID-19. And we have a little problem because that product works, but there is a discrepancy. The product is not the way it was promised to be delivered. So if the amount was a certain amount, then there was always 30% less. And it turns out, I read a report yesterday, what really made me sick to my stomach, that was rerouted through Mr. Trump's corporations. And for some strange reason, all of a sudden, people that have nothing to do with the United States are getting injections protected by somebody connected with Mr. Trump. And so when people are so fascinated with a man that screws them around, I wonder what is wrong with them. And so I always go back to the Bible and I try to figure out, what does the Bible say? Is the original New Covenant teachings the embodiment of extremism as our liberal thinkers would reason today? Yes, it is extreme until we become aware of the fact that we dwell in a prison. It is a man-made, a self-made prison. Our true self exists in a 12-dimensional reality beyond even our imagination and ability to comprehend. And because our real soul, our presence, is so reduced by our three-dimensional thinking of this incomplete realm, that our intelligence and our power of the mind has been diminished to a mere fraction of our potential. Otherwise, I won't be able to explain it. What we see right now, rational thinking politicians claiming to be believers in the Word of God, praying the prayers of God, and acting like morons. Why is that? Or is the foundation that they're working under, is that foundation different? See, as we would question the wisdom of a parent who keeps their child locked up in a room and separated from the outside world, not until they comprehend, does the term extremism be only applicable to the poverty in which we dwell, can we walk the path that the men and women of wisdom have called the way. See, if you do something so extreme, and there are now 140 senators following Trump, claiming that the man is not treated well, somebody stole something which never belonged to him in the first place, the people had spoken, and yet they are now protesting today. So when we come to that understanding, then we say, what is the essence of living under a law that is not constrained? Then it's on top of it a support of the body of Christ. Let's check out what is going on. We know that there is a support of the body of Christ because we have heard Mr. Pat Robertson, we have heard John Hagee, we have heard Kenneth Copeland, we have heard Paula White, we have heard Sid Roth and many, many, many others prophesying about Trump. But what was the special deal? They made a deal. What kind of a deal? With Trump, he only talks in money. He either loses the money or he promises you money as long as you do what he says. So there is a monetary benefit for the church. But is this a spiritual benefit? For over 2,000 years, in every generation, we have doomsday prophets predicting the end time as Armageddon and the second coming. From pulpits across the world, they preach the second coming and teach believers to wait next coming of Jesus, which is imminent. Thus, confronted with what we are in a grave deception that alienated believers from receiving the promises of the gospel, an act that has robbed them of the opportunity to enter the promise of life. In other words, we were supposed to be alive, folks, not sitting ducks waiting for a dud like the Trump, Are we facing an outright break with reality? Or can we see through the nonsense what is going on? We cannot call this the rapture or Armageddon, nor entering the kingdom of God. Suppose the church doctrine dictates that a believer must wait on the second coming for the Lord. Then this alienates modern Christians from the truth and the gospels that promise us a different aspect. The church itself inhibited and blocked believers' congregations from knowing the truth of the promise of the gospel, which provokes the question, why does the church promote counterfeit teaching that robs the people of their spiritual inheritance? By supporting that behavior, we see from Trump and his cronies what the results are: chaos, stealing, theft, bureaucracy? No, but we see a tremendous outpour of scary stuff. I don't want to go into details because you can watch all the other stations. I want to share with you that there is something that you can break, but you folks have to make up your mind. If you are just following a procedure, because this is our man, now bless your heart, there is another way. Now, I always go back to the foundation, Adam Clark's monumental commentary on the Bible. This was written down in 1800. It is based on the Calvinist. He's a gentleman that thinks in the old-fashioned way. And in this commentary, he wrote, except there comes a falling away first. He's talking about 2 Thessalonians 2, verse 3 to 4. We have the original word apostia in our word, apostasy. And by this term, we understand a dereliction of the essential principles of religious truth. It's either a total abandonment of Christianity itself, or such a corruption of its doctrines renders the whole system completely inefficient to salvation. What am I saying in the difficult terminology? He said, either it is the telling you the truth or it is screwing you. That's basically the bottom line, and making it ineffective to even believe in your salvation. By what this apostasy means, it is a question which has not yet and perhaps never will be answered to general satisfaction. It means that the apostles predict that soon the true religion of Jesus would cease to exist in this world. Uh-oh. Do satanic forces rule the church? Yes, folks. Is Satan running the church? Have you ever considered that? Now, there are a lot of things, and I am going back because there is something that you need to understand. 325. These events, and it was also in the Clark commentary, these events came to pass. They documented from an historical perspective, quoting John Wesley, that fatal period when Emperor Constantine called himself a Christian. From the time onward, the Christians had no more of the spirit of Christ than the heathens. This is John Wesley in the Wesley Works, Volume 7, Sermon 89, page 26-27. Modern non-Catholic Christians reason they separated themselves from what they often portrayed as the pagan church of Rome at the Protestant Reformation. The facts are that they continue to preach the second coming from a Catholic mindset and dogmatic perception. They will continue to promote a lie that enslaves believers. Folks, do satanic forces rule the church? Does Satan rule the church? If we take the analysis of Paul's prediction that satanic forces ruled the church but dictated every aspect of Christian doctrine, and that the Christians would worship Satan as God, having the highest place and authority in the Christian church, he acts as God, taking upon himself God's titles and attributes, and arrogating to himself the authority that belongs to the highest, although many faithful believers, clergy, pastors, and religious authorities today recognize the church's hearsay in the 4th century. They could not reveal with certainty that the church never recovered from the darkness and the corruption they imposed upon the teachings of the church by ruthless political politicians of the past. Essential foundational principles and indispensable elements of the new covenant knowledge of what is continuously referred to in the Bible as the mysteries of God is absent from the thinking of the body of the faithful believers to this very day. And that is why we see today the phony baloney going on, people standing up, I'm a believer, I'm a Christian, yes, praise the Lord, but I refuse to accept the loss of Mr. Trump, because Mr. Trump, and then they go on and on and on. Are they serving God? Ay, 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 ay. He who is not busy being born is busy dying. Dylan, maybe remember the song. They portrayed Armageddon or the rapture in scriptures as feared, whereas another element to the theological equation is rarely mentioned or discussed. It can be demonstrated by merely examining how we translate Matthew 24 verse 8, where the King James Bible states that Armageddon is the beginning of sorrows. The New Living Translation says the beginning of the horror to come, which the correct and little used interpretation of those who stand on our street corners proclaiming that we should repent. You found in the Revised Standard Version where it reads that all this is but the beginning of the birth pangs. What they portray in the above as achieving wholeness by bringing about the subsequent stages of birth, which is the condition of body and mind necessary to inherit the gospel promise. In the words of the 60th philosopher Bob Dylan of his life when he was a student of Hebrew mysticism, when he said, he who is not busy being born is busy dying. Now there are two ways. What Jesus portrayed as a narrow path, or the way, the truth, and the light, and the broad way that most of mankind walks to their demise on the broad way. Folks, if you're doing today what I see you do on TV, acting like a moron in behalf of Mr. Moron, Trump himself, you are walking the broad way. You're not even close to the narrow way, because this is not how Yeshua would act. Yeshua would never take that position that Trump demolishes any civility. Suppose you fail to bring about the next stage of birth, so you are about to be born as a new creation. You basically commit suicide for a little fetus. Satanic forces that have ruled the church are ruling it again. This kind of mentality. Satanic forces rule the church, because what you contemplate tomorrow is sad. When Jesus referenced to the coming of the kingdom, stating that it would never come in the manner it would be was seen in the outer world, we're talking about the prodigal son. We know that the prodigal son was in the outside, in the outskirts. In the perception of the parable of the prodigal son, the people in his life, in his world, were dead. Another disciple said to him, Lord, first let me go and bury my father. But Jesus told him, follow me and let the dead bury the dead. That was in Matthew 8, 21, 22. And the actual resurrection of the dead is the return of the prodigal son to the Edenic kingdom. And this is why Paul wrote, therefore he says, awake you that sleep and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give you light. Ephesians 5 verse 14. That is what Paul admits, that he has not yet achieved the resurrection. I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering, being conformed to him in his death, so that I may somehow attained to the resurrection from the dead. Not that I have already obtained all this or have already been perfected, but I press on in Philippians 10 verse 12. The resurrection is a symbolic portrayal of the final birth, the end times, also known as Armageddon. Unless you are resurrected from the death while still in the physical body, this resurrection cannot happen after you physically die. Folks, I can go on and on and on, and I try to keep it nice and tidy. So tough times never last, but tough people, they do. God bless you. Bye for now. Thank you.
Thank you.